Now, after successful recording of sample application, now is the time where we can playback the script. Now, playback a script, we'll be doing some settings part there. We'll be getting a particular code what we have recorded, okay, a ready-made code which got automatically recorded. So in that code, what we'll do is we'll just try some few options, like we'll be, you know, slowing down the script execution, because normally when we execute, it is very fast. Okay, so it is very difficult for us to understand how is the process going on. So what we'll do is we'll try some trick here. We'll slow down the execution by inserting a sleep command here, by inserting a sleep command. And also, if you don't want to insert sleep command, okay, what we can do is we can go to the setting options, and there we can execute each step slower pace. Okay, so these two options we'll be trying out in this particular video. Let us see practically. Now let us see practically how do we execute a particular script, or we can say how do we playback it. In the previous video, we have seen how to record. We have recorded Classics Java Asample application. So now what I'll do is I'll try to execute. But before executing, what I'll do is I'll just try to, you know, properly rename the script which I've already recorded. I'll just right click on the script, rename, type as a_classics_java_asample, click on finish. So just one thing what I've done is a_. I'll keep on creating scripts and I'll keep on writing in the alphabetical order like A, B, C, D and all. Okay. Now, after renaming it, what I'll do is I'll just try to execute. There are two methods to execute. You can go to the script menu bar, select the option as run, or else on the toolbar, if you observe, there's a run option given here that says run functional test script. You can choose either of them. I'll click on the toolbar button and yeah, you'll get a dialog box. What it says, when you execute the script, a result will be created that is nothing but known as log. What is the name of the log you want to create? So you can see the name of the script and name of the log by default would be same. But if you want to just modify, you can just change the name here itself. So I'll keep it as it is and I'll click on finish. Once you click on finish, RFT window will get minimized and playback monitor will be displayed on your screen, which will show you the current step which has been executed. So here you can see that is a playback monitor, and whatever steps are mentioned, those steps will be executed onto your application. Okay, so you can see the Rick tumbler is selected, credit card number is entered, expiry date, place order, and so on. So whatever steps we have recorded, same steps would be emulated or they would be executed. Once the execution is done, okay, you'll be getting a log results. Okay, this is my laptop settings which says, do you want to set up the Internet Explorer 11? So I'll just click on ask me later. Now what it says, this is a format, a log format named as HTML format. This is a by default format you'll be getting, where you'll be getting the script details, like you are starting the application. You can see that's a start application and the script is ending, and here in between you can see the time and date when the script started, time and date when the script ended. And on the left hand side, you can see there's a status which is given as pass. Okay, so this is the default log format which you'll be able to see for the first time. Now you can change the format of the log. We'll see it later on how we can change it. Right now what I'll do is I'll click on close button. Now if you have observed, when we executed the script, it was a bit fast. So what if I want to slow down the execution? So if you want to slow down, what you can do is you can go to configure, or you can say go to window menu bar, select the option as preferences. Now these are the backend settings which are visible here. These are backend settings here. So from here, what you have to do is you have to select the option given as functional test. In the functional test, you can see the option multiply all time options by one. So all time options in the backend, there are so many options for execution, for mouse click, for keyboard click, which we'll see later on. But right now what I'll do is I'll uncheck this use default and make it as by 30. Multiply all time options by 30. So after every step, it will pause for 30 seconds to go to the next step. Now I'll click on apply, click on OK. And now you can click on this run button. Click on, yeah, you can see it is again asking you the log name, which is already created, a_classic_java_asample. So what I'll do is I'll just put underscore and I'll put as delay, something delay, and click on finish. RFT window will minimize, playback monitor should be displayed, and you can see the speed of execution will be reduced. So observe the time required. It is very slow as compared to the previous one. Though it is not 30 seconds, it is multiplied by 30, much slower than the previous execution part. You can see the speed has been reduced. So it is not actually the 30 seconds. I'll tell you why it has been multiplied, why it is, how slow it is. So this is the format, HTML format, we are getting the result. And here at the bottom, if you see, Internet Explorer restricted this web page from running ActiveX scripts. So I'll just click on this allow blocked content. So on the left hand side, you'll get the status, failure, warning, and none. What you call failures, warnings, and the verification point. All of them are showing as none. I'll click on close. Now, I'll go to this Windows menu bar, select the option as preferences. So we'll select the option here as given as functional test. So multiply all time options by 30. So earlier I said it will pause for 30 seconds, but not actually 30 seconds. Let me just expand this functional test, expand this playback. And here if you see mouse delays, they are not given in seconds. Okay, it is 0.01 seconds, 0.005 seconds. So whatever the times are mentioned here, they are been multiplied by 30. Okay, so not necessary it will come as 30 seconds. So it will come as somewhere 1 or 2 seconds. You can just assume here. Same way, other delays, we'll talk about this delays in the next video. But here, just let me show you, those are not 1 second. They are 0.25, 0.01, 0.5. So here, for example, if I multiply it 0.5 into 30 seconds, which come into 15 seconds. Okay, so delay after top level window activates, and so on. So all the times are been multiplied by 30. That is given here, functional test multiply by 30. Multiply all time options by 30. So I'll click on apply and click on OK. This is one method by which you can, you know, slow down your execution. I have written just 30 in example. You can just put as 50, 60, whatever you want. Now there's one more option to slow down the execution. That means you can just pause it before the steps starts. For example, you can just type a Java command that is sleep 10 seconds, sleep in bracket 10. So the time which is given 10, it is in the seconds. Make sure you put as a very small case. They are Java code is a case sensitive. So if you put starting capital S, it won't accept. Okay, so make sure all should be small case. So I've put at sleep 10 and right. So I'll just click on this run button. Here, if you want, you can just change the name. I'll put as sleep, click on finish. You can see on the screen, on the playback monitor, it's showing as sleep. That means it is executing that particular command for 10 seconds. Once it is done, it will proceed for the next step. So why it is required? Sometimes you want to see what exactly is happening while the execution. So at before any step, you can put a sleep command. It will pause for 10 seconds. You can analyze the result, what it is showing during the runtime itself, right? So these are the remaining other very simple and easy steps. It will just normally execute. There's nothing new in this. Right, so the execution is done and the result is shown into HTML format, which is by default. So I'll click on close. Now I'll go back to this Windows and go back to preferences. And what I'll do is I'll make it as use default. Okay, I'll not make it as 30, use default. Click on apply, click on OK. Right, so if you want to see the logs, because I've executed 3 times, in this left hand side functional test projects, you can see under the logs, we have 3 logs which have been created. One is the normal sample, second is delay, and third one is sleep. So you can just double click on any one log. Okay, it will expand and you can see the results step by step in that place itself, right? So I'll just click on this close button. Right, so I hope you have understood how to work on this playback script, or you can say execution of the recorded script itself. And that's all for this video.
Tutorialspoint.com. Simply easy learning.